guys and gals. I'm here with video. Today we'll be looking at the Amazon exclusive Ahsoka Tano Jedi Starfighter 2-pack from Jazzwares' Micro Galaxy Squadron line. If you are a Mint Box collector, here is what it looks like. There you go. It's a box. If you're unaware, Amazon has a semi-new policy. It's been around for a little while now, where by default, they will ship items with a shipping label on whatever you get. There is an option during checkout to opt out of that. I assume it's a way to cut back on waste, because Amazon boxes, who doesn't have a bunch of Amazon boxes? I got tons of them, but I use them to ship stuff, so whatever. But if you're a Mint Box collector, fret not, because this does come in its own shipper by default. So I do have a shipping label on the other side of this. Doesn't bother me. I toss this kind of stuff. But just keep that in mind if you are buying this. If you don't want a shipping label on this, go ahead and check that box during checkout. This is actually still in stock at Amazon. Quick little thing. I thought it was kind of cute that Jazzwares includes a little thank you card. I think it's a little touch that I like. Here's the back of the box if you are at all curious. We're going to show these things in detail, like literally right now. So, it's there. These guys individually are about $17, I think. $16, $17, around there. The Jedi Starfighter was initially a chase. I know it was announced with Wave 1. I'm not sure when it actually came out. I've never seen them in retail. They're chases. They're going to be hard to find. But there is kind of some cost cutting to make these $25. For starters, you don't get the hyperdrive ring that came with the initial release of this. That may bother some people. It may not. As much as I like the hyperdrives, I don't really display my ships with them. So while I would love to have one for Ahsoka's ship, I don't. And that's okay. I will live. And while you do have two ships, you only get one teeny tiny Ahsoka and one teeny tiny R7. Which, again, might not be a problem for some people. I don't know which of these two ships I like more. I really don't. Believe me when I say that I initially didn't plan to buy both versions of every ship. Somehow, that is just happening because one way or another, there is something that is drawing me to get all of them. There are reasons that I may get to if I ever cover the rest of these, but here's how these look all together. I probably should put these a little closer. I didn't think I had as much space as I would need to put them all together, but here's how these all look at the moment. I think there is an Ayla Secura, is that how you pronounce her name? Variant out there of the Starfighters. I don't know. These do look good together, but I can't decide which I like more. So for the moment, I kind of have them all, and it's a lot, but they do look really good together. Now back to these guys. I'm going to try to get my white balance to compensate quite a bit. This little kind of whitish color in person, it's a lot more of an off-white kind of cream. It's a lot yellower on here, and that might be because of all the blackness. I don't know, but I'll try to compensate. As far as I can tell, this is the same release as the original. This does look great. So has all the landing gears, all the markings. I haven't seen a side by side of this and the original chase release, but I know all the deco is the same. So everything looks great. You can of course tuck the landing gears up. On one of mine, it is worth noting, it's like it was inserted a little off-center. I had to push this back peg in to fully lock it in, and I'm still not sure it's there. It doesn't really fit as flush as the other, so there's a little bit of a QC problem with these. And I've noticed the only other Starfighter I had before Ahsoka's was Obi-Wan's, and I've noticed they've done a slight mod. It's the same with my Anakin, but initially there was a much larger gap at the bottom where Obi-Wan could kind of lie inside, and you may not even notice, but they've now added this little kind of wall that isn't there previously. I'm guessing that's to keep the figure from kind of sliding, whatever, down into the cockpit, but I liked not having that wall there because Obi-Wan's legs would kind of wrap around this little joystick kind of console and secure him a bit better. Anakin and Ahsoka, they don't have that, so they kind of flop around inside the cockpit quite a bit. Again, I don't know if the chase version of this ship has that as well. That may be an ongoing change they made after this guy. I don't know, but it is worth noting. I do kind of want to put a slight piece in place to lock their legs in. Onto the Interceptor. I really like these ships. I do. And the deco, it's really good, but this is an issue where I can't tell if this is meant to be this way or if it's a problem. You can see there's a little blotch that I at first thought that someone spilled coffee on my ship, but I think it's just part of the weathering process. It does have a kind of dirty used look to it, which for the most part looks fine, but there are just random little blotches. So you could just say, yeah, it's mud, it's rain, it's muddy water, whatever. I do have more paint issues on this one. Some of the yellow isn't quite as crisp as it should be. There's a little bit of an overspray on some parts of it. But for the most part, it's fine. I did try to scrape off. There was a big glob of white paint back there. So I do have more paint problems on this than I have my other ships. Nothing I've noticed, at least. But overall, it looks good. The landing gears do lock up like you would expect. And the S-foils do open like the other interceptors. I wish there was a way to open them at least one side at a time and I have to do it all individually. But I do like how that looks. Like, that is a big selling point for me. If the S-foils couldn't do that, I don't think I would want the ships. But yeah, I think that's a great look. The little gaps inside, they are hollow. I think you can see my finger through there. But yeah, I think it looks great. Now on to our figures. These are a little interesting. While the Ahsoka pilot is the exact same, I'm gonna try to hold her. She's so little. She's a little excited. She wants to put her arms up. Here is the release that came with the blind box with the speeder bike. They are the same mold. The paint is about the same. It's a little sloppier on the newer one. It's a little more muted, but they are the same figure. So there's that. One little issue that mine has is the arms are really, really loose, which is it's a little annoying until you want to have her going, yay, yay, so happy. Articulation is the same. The legs can move. And the arms, I may try to tighten them up. I'm not sure if I really can, given how they're constructed. But really loose arms. I'm glad that I have a spare Ahsoka. And we're just going to put her in the Starfighter. See, if you put her inside, there's nothing to really lock her legs in place. And hang on. There you go. Once you get her in, she's very, very small. And she kind of flops around inside there. We're going to close that and just kind of... There you go. She flops. So what I want to do is put a little piece of styrene between where her legs are to lock them in place. The Interceptor doesn't have that problem, and I like that it's a little, not better constructed, but you can see there's an actual grip in place. It's a lot more detailed too, I should also point out. And so you can take her and fit her right in. And while it is, you can still knock her out if you're still going crazy, she does hold in place a bit better. Thanks to that little stopper for her legs. I just want to point out how much better detailed the interior of that is. This isn't bad. I'm not trying to knock against this, but, you know, there's a little more going on in the Interceptor than there's the Starfighter. We're going to leave Ahsoka in there for now. Now, R7, at first I thought was just, you know what, it's just another droid release. And it is. It is the exact same mold as the R2 and R4? No, not R4. I forget who came with Obi-Wan. It's gone. It's left my memory. But there is an interesting little paint difference. So here's R7. Okay. And just to make it easier, here's how he looks with the other two droids. There might be more, but these are the ones that I have. But one thing that I've noticed that hasn't really bothered me before, I don't want to call it lazy because these are tiny, but the previous droids, their domes, they don't have that kind of segmented paint job. It's just a glob. And I've kind of been like, okay, that's fine. But for some reason, this little guy, and I don't know if the regular release of him with the Chase Starfighter has this, but his is actually painted. It actually has all the little segments. That's an interesting change that I would love to see going forward if they could all have that. It's a very minor thing. It's only minorly bothered me before, but the fact that I know that they can do it, if they continue doing it this way, it will be annoying. Because now I know, you guys can do it, Jazzwares. You can. It's right there. And of course, you can fit R7 in the droid port of the Starfighter. Fits in right in there. It does have the button on the bottom that will pop him out. Or you can put him, I say him, I mean, I guess I should say it, and the little port there, and it just pegs right in place, whichever you like. There's no release mechanism. You just kind of grab it by the legs, the shoulders, the knees, whatever you want to call it, and it just comes out like that. And that's really it for this set. As I mentioned, it is available still on Amazon.com. It's sold out I think instantly. And then it came back in stock, and I want to say it's been in stock ever since. Go ahead and pop all these little guys out again. And yeah, if unless you really want the hyperdrive ring for the Starfighter, which I admit I still kind of do, you can find the original release of this on eBay for $36. If you don't really care about that and you just want to have Ahsoka in one of her ships, $25 for this, I think, is a really good deal. If you're someone like me who can't decide which version of the Jedi Starfighters you actually like more, this could be a really great deal for you, and I would say check it out. Again, link in the description down below. But I do believe that is all that I can say for this video. I've probably talked more than I should have. I do that, I know. And I'm gonna go. I thank you guys for watching if you've made it this far. I hope you've enjoyed it somewhat. I will see you around, and take care. Bye.